Thanks for joining us tonight. It is a sad night for two communities connected by deadly shootings.
It all started with the brazen murder of an artist in St. Paul that the police chief called one of the most cold-blooded things he's ever seen. That shooting yesterday evening led police to Belle Plaine this morning, where St. Paul officers were involved in a deadly shooting involving the suspect. We have team coverage tonight. Danny Spiewak is in St. Paul with what we're learning about the artist who was killed.
But we begin with Gordon Severson in Belle Plaine to explain what happened. Gordon?
Yeah, the BCA just cleared the scene here about an hour ago here in Belle Plaine. Pretty much the entire neighborhood was blocked off with police tape, but we saw a lot of investigators focusing their attention on this area just outside of St. John's Lutheran Church. We're told by the family that the suspect actually lived in a house just on the other side of the church here. And St. Paul police say somewhere in this area, their officers encountered the suspect. They say he was armed with a gun, and at some point, police say those officers fired their weapons and killed him.
Prairie Street, Chestnut Street for a shots fired incident with a suspect downed.
Radio traffic from Broadcastify went out Thursday morning as Belle Plaine residents received an early morning wake-up call.
I heard three shots. I thought it was fireworks.
Because here in this town, Kelly Shaughnessy says fireworks at 6:30 in the morning is more likely than gunshots.
No, never. Not in this small town. Uh-uh.
It was quite the morning.
Renee Schultz also heard the gunshots, and she too thought the sound had to be something else.
And I didn't think anything of it until my sister-in-law called me and just said, "Are you okay? Because there's a, you know, shooting. You know, by your dad's church, which is across the street."
St. Paul police say their officers shot and killed a suspect who is connected to a murder that happened around 13 hours earlier in St. Paul.
Very, very quickly established evidence and information and leads that led us to identify a vehicle and get photographs of the driver of that vehicle.
Police say that information led them to a home in Belle Plaine. Officers set up a perimeter and were preparing to make contact when police say the suspect came out of the home with a handgun. At some point, officers fired their weapons and killed the suspect. Family members have identified the man as 29-year-old Chantrell Murdoch, a father of four who lived in Belle Plaine with his four kids.
I heard the news, came here, found out what happened. I didn't know what to think. It didn't really make sense, you know?
Police are also trying to make sense of the shooting in St. Paul. The chief says right now they believe the shooting was completely random.
One of the most cold-blooded things I've ever seen in my life. And as a random, what appears to be right now, a random act performed in a manner like that, is something I've never seen anything like that, even in a movie.
Meanwhile, neighbors are doing their best to stay calm and carry on with their daily routines while they wait to hear more about what happened.
Just being on the edge, a little scary.
And the BCA has taken over this part of the investigation since the shooting involved officers firing their weapons. We are hoping to learn more from the BCA about what happened here the moments before those shots were fired. Back to you.
Wow. All right. Thank you, Gordon.
Well, now Danny Spiewak picks up our coverage in St. Paul. Danny, what have you learned there?
Well, police have not yet identified the woman, the artist, who was shot and killed in Lowertown last night. But in the last couple of hours, we're starting to learn more about her, who she was, and just the circumstances that led up to her shooting yesterday. That was just after 5 p.m. The victim, we know, was a member of the Lowertown Lofts Artist Cooperative. That's a building in Lowertown with 28 artists who live and work together in nearby spaces near the Union Depot. Co-op members gathered near the scene to pay tribute today say she was a beloved member of their community. In a statement, the group said that she was killed working on an art project. Police confirmed that, said she was actually on her knees working on this mural when the shooter opened fire. The group said that they were feeling shock and grief as we grapple with the unimaginable. And neighbors in other buildings in Lowertown, everybody seems to know each other or know somebody who knows somebody else. They say that they're struggling with this as well.
When you hear just an innocent person got shot just doing her own passionate artwork, you can't even understand the feelings I go through, especially with the people that were sitting right here watching and all the seeing stuff that was happening.
And we talked with a few members of the artist cooperative today. They say at some point they do want to share the story of this person, of this woman. The artist, they say, was an incredible part of their community, but they're waiting for police to notify family and for the official identity to come out before they do that. Back to you.
Just so tragic and seemingly senseless. Thank you, Danny.